Yo, this is your boy James over at Spectrum Go, bringing you guys the latest angers in Wizards Unite content. And today, we are here to talk about the Quidditch Cup Brilliant Event Part 1, which details just dropped today, day before the event, but they're here and we need it so we can know how to plan and to help you guys get through this event as efficient as possible. Now, this event, like I talked about earlier, is starting tomorrow, May 5th, 11 a.m. Pacific time through May 12th, 11 a.m. Pacific time. And what's so cool is it's the first event that's continuing the theme of Quidditch for the month of May. So your boy is hyped, super hyped about this month, and this brilliant event is kicking everything off. So without further ado, let's dive right into the details. Starting with what's coming back. We have the Brilliant Portkey 1.5 kilometers. That's coming back from the previous brilliant events, along with the spell energy on the ground that's guaranteeing you five spell energy each time you pick it up. Also, what's coming back, restricted books, you have a chance to get 15, and spellbook rewards as well, you have a chance to get eight spellbooks. So, yo, that is super clutch. Your boy needs them. I'm so close to knocking out Magic Zoology. Also, some coins, some ingredients, Extinglo ingredients, which I just used a bunch during this past community day. So, super excited about the rewards and the tasks for this event. Speaking of tasks, they're going to be, some of them will be centered around Arrestable Momentum, which, as you see here, I swear, I did this before I even found out about the details, because I usually change the spell before the each month and stuff. So, yo, that's crazy. It makes sense, May, all that jazz. But there will be an increase in foundables where you have to spell cast Arrestable Momentum. You got the Bludger and the Snitch, which correlates with the Quidditch theme for this month. So, super cool to see. Now, without further ado, let's go over the foundables, brilliant foundables specifically for this event. Starting with the two foundables you will be seeing on your map. We have the brilliant Nimbus 2000 alongside brilliant Angelina Johnson, Quidditch. Both of those make sense. So, yo, I get it. I see what you're doing, Harry Potter Wizards Unite. Then, from the brilliant 1.5 kilometer Portkey, we will be rewarded Nearly Headless Nick, which is clutch. Then, when using a brilliant runestone while riding the night bus, you will be rewarded the Enter House Quidditch Cup. And then, once completing tasks, you will be rewarded James Potter's plaque, which I cannot wait to hear Harry's dialogue, assuming Harry is going to be talking about this topic concerning his dad's plaque. And then the last one will be the trophy case. So those are your six fragments for that brilliant registry page. Now, yo, let's go over the tasks right quick. All right, so the first task we have for this event, we have to return 3 magical games and sports foundables. We begin some snowdrops, which is clutch because your boy needs some Extinglos after this past weekend. Then return 5 brilliant Nimbus 2000s. You'll be getting some Ream Blood, along with collect 3 ingredients or portmanteaus from off your map, where you'll be getting some strong Extinglo potions. Once you've done all of that, you'll be able to get some XP, brilliant XP, restricted books, and Dark Detector, which is clutch. But new, I think, is spell energy. You'll be rewarded spell energy once you complete each task, which is very nice to see. They are listening, because spell energy is a need. Moving on to task number 2, we have Brew, Tonic for Trace Detection 2 times, which, tip for you guys, make sure you have your tonics already ready, brewed, and ready to collect before you get to task number 2. So once you get here, you'll be able to collect it and go as fast as you can and as smoothly as you can while trying to complete this task. You get some toadstools along with returning 7 bludgers. I talked about it earlier with the increase in Arrestable Momentum foundables. The bludger is one of those foundables, so you need to return 7 of those. You get some BBEs or Brew for brain elixirs once you've done that. Then cast arrest of momentum. Here we go again. Four times, which is cool because they both correlate. They both kind of work together, the bludges and the arrest of momentum. So very cool. Get some silver keys. Total rewards, James Potter's plaque. XP, brilliant XP, restricted books, and spell energy again, which keep giving it to me. I will take it. Task number three, you have to use Tonic for Trace Detection two times. Another tip for you guys, try to have at least five Tonic for Trace Detections for this entire event. You're going to need to use two here and then another three for the bonus assignment. So make sure you have that all roaring to go. Then you get some unicorn hair, which is a must. Extimulos. Return 10 brilliant Angelina Johnsons. Get some potent Extimulo potions. And then return 5 magical games and sports foundables. Another silver key, which will go towards the port keys. Which, another tip for you guys, I think that's like the third one I have for you guys. Make sure you have at least 5 port key slots ready for this event so you can get the 5 fragments needed for Nearly Headless Nick so you can place that in your registry. Once you've completed all of that, you'll get some XP, brilliant XP, restricted books again, and some spell energy again. The fourth and final task for this event will be rewarding spell books. Each task will reward spell books, so that's 3 total. But what we have to do to get those spell books, cast Arrest of Momentum 15 times, return 10 golden snitches, and earn 5,000 wizarding XP from traces. They said from traces specifically, but once you've completed that, along with the 3 spell books from knocking out those tasks, you get a trophy case, some coin, restricted books, spell energy, and Ravenclaw and Hufflepuff Quidditch Crest, which is cool to see. And we already know, we got a sneak peek of what the part 2 brilliant event, the Quidditch Cup, will be featuring Gryffindor and Slytherin. So we'll probably get those 2 for part 2. So pretty cool, excited about that, especially as a fellow Hufflepuff. But let's move on to bonus assignment for this event. Now, the rewards for this bonus assignment will be giving you 15 total in the Quidditch Through the Age through the Ages fragments. So that's going to be cool. Please, my other tip for you guys, make sure you don't waste those fragments. Make sure you have space for them in your registry. So, make sure, that's my fourth tip for you guys, make sure you have space for these fragments because they are valuable. But what do you need to get these fragments? You will need to earn 10,000 wizarding XP. This is where you can use your gifts from your friends to help towards this count. Then use Tonic for Trace Detection 3 times. Return 30 brilliant foundables. Cast Arrest of Momentum 45 times and return 20 golden snitches. Once you've done that, you get some wizarding XP, brilliant XP, 5 more spell books, a title, and some spell energy. 30 to be exact. Just like with every event, we have a complimentary gift, an SOS bundle, a brilliant bundle, and a bonus bundle, which some of these is looking pretty good, but spend according to your playstyle and need. But that being said, that's going to be it. That is going to be it for today's video. Hopefully the tips and stuff I have for you guys were helpful, and super excited about this event and to hear your thoughts. We will be live streaming tomorrow like we always do with the first day of the event. So make sure you have those notification bells rung and ready so you'll know when we go live tomorrow, Sue and I. But you boys going to get out of here. If you are new, consider subscribing to the channel. Here you'll be getting all the latest and greatest of Wizards Unite content, gameplay, tips, news, and updates. So if that's something you're into concerning this game, Harry Potter Wizards Unite, consider subscribing. Leave a comment, drop a like. All of that helps the video, helps with the YouTube algorithm, all that jazz. Check us out on our various forms of social media, Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. I hope you guys are having an awesome day. May the 4th be with you. Today is Monday, May the 4th, so hope you guys are enjoying your day as well. But I'll see you guys in the next video. Until next time.